Hey guys, it is Sunday and it's the first day using the new vlog camera for a whole vlog, so hopefully it works out okay since I had to return the last one for an audio issue. I did some test recordings and I think it's okay. I mean, I also thought the other one was okay in the initial test, so we'll see. Fingers crossed it all works out. I'm doing a variety of things today. So far I've just been doing some housework. I have more to do. I was gonna do laundry on Tuesday and didn't, and I since have not done it. So I have a lot of laundry to do today, and just like dishes, cleaning the floors, that kind of thing. And I wanna work on my sculpture a little bit and then work on advent calendar prep stuff because I really slowed down on that ever since the estimated shipping date was changed. I just slowed right down. Then I panicked because I thought it was coming last Friday all of a sudden, but then it wasn't. So I don't know when it's coming, but probably within the next, like in a week or so, week to week and a half, I would say. No, probably within the next 1 week, because the manufacturer said it would arrive by the 20th at the latest. So yeah, anyway, I just need to get my butt back in gear, basically. I washed up some dishes just now and I was gonna vacuum the floors, but Christian's using the vacuum to clean the bathrooms right now. So I'll just wait a little bit. In the meantime, I'm gonna get cracking on the sculpture. I don't plan on adding anything new to it today. I'm just going to tweak the existing stuff that's down on the clay right now. Like I have the face here, I'm just gonna tweak what I have so that I like it more, because I was saying in the last video, it doesn't look enough like my sketch. And I did say I was gonna fix the eyes to be smaller to match the sketch more. I also didn't like how the chin was too big. Like it looks proportional, maybe even too small compared to real proportions, but I think it looks too big compared to my 2D art, and so I'm gonna try to fix that. People were saying the ears were crooked, so I gotta fix that. And I might actually trim them down to be a little bit smaller. And I got a suggestion to just flatten them back on the head a little bit more, because I had them almost exactly sticking out sideways, because I draw them like that, but it just doesn't translate well to 3D. So yeah, I'll tweak that. And I also got a comment saying the brow bone is too, like it's protruding too much and makes her look like a Neanderthal, so I can smooth that out too. It's better to just tweak this stuff now instead of at the end being like, oh, I wish I would have fixed it while I still had the chance, you know, that sort of thing. When I finished it up the other day, the thought of trimming down the chin, for example, I was like, oh, but I spent so much time like smoothing that out and making it look nice. The thought of going back in and trying to fix it is just so daunting, but I know it's gonna be worth it because I wanna be happy with the end result, right? So I think it's worth it to go in and make the fixes now. I just have to be careful I don't mess up other places I've already sculpted. Like I don't wanna mess up the hair or anything, so yeah. Okay, time to begin. I'm somewhere in the middle, try to find myself again. But life is one big riddle, all the future and what's been. Cause it's the way it goes, and I will never know why you let me go. Look to the left, look to the right, nothing can stop me in the night, like I am leaving all the bad stuff. And trying to remain so strong, I know it's good if I'm alone. I got it, I gotta go. It's the way it goes, and I will never know why you let me go. Look to the left, look to the right, nothing can stop me in the night, like I am leaving all the bad stuff. And trying to remain so strong, I know it's good if I'm alone. I got it, I gotta go, 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 run. Running to better times,
Okay, I have made my modifications. I keep seeing extra lumps I want to smooth out. Ugh, the ears are not quite even still, but they're close enough. I decided to add a piece of hair in front of the ears too. I think it looks a little more like the artwork now. It's not exact, obviously, but I'm much happier with it now. Well, it's now lunchtime, or it's early supper. It's 3 p.m. I'm making this whole box of spring rolls just so they're all cooked. We can have leftovers tomorrow or whenever. And then I'm making green beans and rice to go with it.
I keep wondering why I feel so mellow, and then I'm like, oh, maybe it's because you keep neglecting your coffee bales. Food was good, and I vacuumed the floors, and now just swapping over the laundry. And then I'm gonna get cracking on some sticker packs. Oh, this is the shirt I should have been wearing today. I've got the pastel pants, but I'm also wearing purple socks. Okay, I might have my white balance a little too yellow because it's looking extra yellow on screen compared to real life. This is the kind of stuff I gotta tweak.
Oh my goodness! What a sneaky kiki.
I was just looking on Amazon for some lashes for the sculpture, and the only doll ones I could find were gonna be shipping from China, like the free shipping that's gonna take like a month and a half to get here. And that's just too long for this sculpture. So instead of using lashes that are specifically for dolls, I'm just gonna use human ones. Well, not human hair, but like, ones made for people. And I was looking at some of those to order. Then I was like, wait, why don't I just look at what I have? Because I never wear my false lashes anyway. So let's just take a peek. I've got a little collection here. I have some magnetic ones, which I'm not gonna be cutting up. So let's set those aside. Got a couple here. I like the inner corners on these ones. They get really small. I mean, I can trim any of these. These ones are nice though because they really taper at the tip. Ew. I can tell I wore one of these pairs before, but the gaps between these are too big. I could almost have to cut each section and stick each one on individually or something. Because I only need a really short section of it, so if the lashes aren't dense enough, it's not really going to work. These would be not too bad. I need to trim them. Obviously, they're too long. Okay, these I've worn before. Very thick. I'm tempted to just go with these ones. Even though they're nice, I'm like, oh, I don't want to waste it on a doll, but I feel that it's not a doll either. But anyway, I feel that way about all of them. I cannot speak right now. I think these are the chosen ones. I'll set these aside. Okay, let's see if I can do this without exposing the stickers again. As I explained before, I've got the light box so that I can make sure the stickers are all the way in before I fold this over so I don't bend any. Oh, yeah, I need tape. Where did I put that? Got it. Okay. I don't have any updates on the advent calendar boxes. I know people are eager for updates. I'll have it when I have it, I guess. Like I said earlier, too, I think probably a week from now is when they're coming. Like, it'll be here within a week, I think, unless there's some kind of delay, but. Just based on the estimated shipping time. And then it's officially full steam ahead. I've been watching so many YouTuber business people lately that I'm like, oh my God, I want like to redo the whole warehouse area. Wait, let me look up the one channel I just came across recently. Her channel's kind of popping right now, so you might have seen her videos. Oh, it's Angela Jasmina. She has an Etsy shop where she does embroidered shirts and other stuff. She has multiple areas to her business, but that's like her main thing. And she has this room full of embroidery machines. And I'm just like, oh, so nice. And Catnip just moved to a new studio again. When I saw that, I was like, what? She's leaving the new place already? It's because she's upgrading to bigger and better things. And I'm like, oh my God.
And she has all these cute lights, and I'm like, oh my god, my warehouse looks like a dumpster.
Okay, I've got this many packaged up so far, and it's time to put the stickers on them. I'll probably have to print off more of these, because this is the last of what I've printed so far, but I'll get through these first. You know the drill. I want to just do this until I go to bed, pretty much. Just spend the entire evening on it and get through as many of them as I can. Because this is the item I'm the most behind on out of all of them. So, just gonna go hard on these. But I don't have that many enamel pins left, so. Hew! Exciting stuff. Part of me does regret bumping the quantity up to 1,000. Because I was originally going to get 500 of everything. But it's just more economical to get 1,000 of everything to keep costs down. Plus, like, the demand for this seemed higher than I originally anticipated. Who knows? Maybe it won't sell that many of them. But initially, I was like, no, I'm only doing 500. There's no way I can prep 1,000 of them in time. Like, I just don't have the time for that. Plus, I was nervous to invest that much money into it, but then once I had my last store update and got the profits from that, I was like, actually, you know what? I am willing to spend the money to get 1,000 of everything. It's just that, man, is it a lot of prep. Taylor has finished his last batch of pins I gave him. He actually finished a few days ago, so I have to pick those up at some point. So he has all the Baroque Brew pins, all the A grades anyway. Without his help, I definitely would not be as far as I am now. And then for stuffing the boxes, I'll see if I can figure out a smooth setup. It's gonna be hard to lay out. Oh, I got a hair in there now. It's gonna be hard to lay out all the merch in a grabbable position. Like, I was trying to think of how I'm gonna do it. Do I, you know, fill smaller bins and lay them out? That way I can reach, like, you know, I want all 12 items within reach to stuff the box. And then maybe I could pass it off to Christian, who can then slip the tray into its sleeve and shut it and then put it in a brown box or something. Like, he could be assembling the brown ones and then putting those in there. Like, I don't know, let's test it out, but some kind of little two-person assembly line. One stuffs the boxes, one sleeves them and puts them in the shipping box. I might need a little bit of crinkle paper in the shipping boxes. I'll have to see once I get the advent boxes, kind of see how much wiggle room is left. But I did buy some crinkle paper, assuming I would need it. Plus, I had leftovers from last time, so yeah. And then in an ideal world, once I receive the boxes, I would have them all stuffed within a week. That might be a little bit ambitious, but I just will put a pause on everything else I do. Like, I won't post any videos that week. I'll still film some footage, but I won't post anything. Probably won't live stream either. Just really focus on getting that last step done as soon as possible. Since everything, like, all the timing's been dependent on receiving the boxes. I mean, plus I'm not done prepping the merch, but, you know, I've been adjusting my pace based on the box schedule too. So those boxes are the big thing we're waiting on before I can commit to a date. I'm so excited though. I don't know. Sorry, I'm just like grumbling incoherently. I'm very excited. It's a pretty ambitious project. This is probably the most ambitious project I've done. I mean, my book was a lot of work, but I was also working with a publisher who helped a lot, and I just had to supply the content. They're the ones who got it printed and did the page layout and stuff like that. So this is something I'm doing mostly by myself, aside from some help from Taylor, and then Christian will help me too, but yeah. I mean, Christian has helped so far, actually. He's done a lot of acrylic charm packaging. Anyway, I'm gonna keep trucking along with this, and I'll give you an update in a bit.
this camera just electrocute me?
Maybe not, but I was powering it off after the last clip and I felt a sting, a sharp sting, and I'm looking at my pinky and there's this circle on it. I don't know if it's visible or not, but what is that? It's like right on the tip. Do you see that? While I was cutting this sheet, I made a realization. Somebody's printed crooked. See, it's like a wider white strip up here and it narrows. That makes it really hard to cut because I line it up at the top, you know, assuming everything's a right angle. Just have to pay extra attention to these few sheets. Since we had our lunch late or our supper early, whatever it ended up being, Christian was wanting to order something. He was craving something sweet, and so we were looking at different places to order from, and we ended up getting blizzards from Dairy Queen, so that's on its way. That'll be my supper, I guess. Supper and dessert. I don't get blizzards often, but I will usually get Oreo, sometimes the strawberry cheesecake one, but right now they have a mocha Oreo one, and I love coffee flavored everything, so I gotta try the Oreo mocha.
Mamma mia, look at that. I might not be able to finish this.
Taste test. Wait. You pour the Oreo in there. Oh my god. The mocha part of it is very strong. Mmm! This probably would be my new favorite Blizzard, but it's just a temporary one, I think. Or at least it's Blizzard of the Month. I don't know if they have this all the time now, but...
And I like that it's in vanilla ice cream. It looks brown because everything's all blended up, but it's in vanilla, which is my preference. So, yes. Look at that poofy tail! Oh my goodness. And yes, the Halloween decorations are still up. Okay, I got roughly 300 done. I'm just judging that based off how many stickers I have left because they're packed in these little stacks of 250 and I've delved into the final stack. So I have 200 and some left to do, especially since I did that and the sculpture stuff and all the cleaning. Ugh, just feels like such a good productive Sunday.
It is now, oh, it's midnight, exactly. So I need to head to bed, but first we have to do the cat shame calendar.
We have Fridays and the weekends to do. So Friday the 13th, dun dun dun. I'm so proud of my poop that when mom and dad are sleeping, I make sure they can smell it by sticking my butt in their faces. Midna makes sure we can smell it by not burying it. Well, usually it's not an issue, but last night it was. It stunk up the basement for like an hour. And for Saturday and Sunday, I cried all night and kept my humans awake. Now it's afternoon and I'm napping. Are you trying to imitate that card?
Anywho, thank you so much for watching and I'll see you guys in the next video.
How much do I want this sticking out? That might actually be good. You know, I want it to be in enough that it's not gonna poke through the clay on accident. So there we have it. Screws, nailed in crooked back piece.